Hi guys, it's unboxing time again, and today I'm unboxing what's rapidly became one of my favourite boxes. For the reason being, basically, you know what's in it when you buy it. You can make the decision whether you buy it. It's not a subscription, so if you just want the one box, you can do that. And it comes from probably one of my favourite retailers and favourite places to buy anything, and that is QVC. This is the TILI box. This is the third one I think I've had, and it is there we go. Can we see it? Yes, we can. TILI. What basically stands for Try It, Love It. And what it is, it's an introduction to some of their products and their brands. So this is the most recent box. I think this is still available. I'll link below so you can get it if you're interested. And it's £20, and it's free postage. And as I say, really easy to get, you know, everything that's in it, and it's gonna be good. You know it's gonna be good. Right, so this basically what it is. Hey 2017, nice of you to drop by. Now that you're here, we've got a whole lot of beauty to get you started. Is there any better way to kick off with a brand new beauty box? So yeah, TILI. So you can get from the QVC UK website. I don't know if QVC US or any of the other QVC franchises do these, but it's a really good idea. So let's see what's inside this one. I already know what's inside, but act surprised. I'm good at surprised. Right, first thing in the box is the new Philip Kingsley Elasticizer. You see that? And it is the, how much do we get? 40 mils. Now, I really like Elasticizer. I do think it makes a difference. My mum at the moment is loving Elasticizer. I've actually got a couple floating around, mini tubes floating around over there that my mum's using at the minute. Because she's on a lot of medication at the minute, and she's having some issues with her hair. So she's using this, and it basically gives you that stretch. Rather than breaking, your hair stretches, it gives it strength, it gives it shine, it gives it condition. And a lot of people can tell on first use, so it's only something you need to use once. It was invented for Audrey Hepburn, which is another reason to love it. And the Philip Kingsley brand is a, it's not a hairdresser brand per se, it's a trichology brand. Now trichologists are actually like doctors for the hair. They diagnose problems with the hair, they have hair clinics where you can actually go if you're having a hair problem. They deal with real problems and medical issues with hair and scalp. And fortunately, Philip Kingsley himself passed away last year, but the brand continues. I think it's under his daughter's leadership now, one of his daughters. And Elasticizer has been the hero product for years. It's 40 years, I think it's over 40 years old now. And this is the new scent. They've just started doing new scents. I think I've got a geranium and something floating around in here. The one I missed that I really wanted to try was rhubarb and rose, unfortunately, but I missed that one. Now, this is the new one. So I'll just put a little bit out. So that's what... it's really what it looks like. Now what it is, it's a pre-shampoo contour treatment. Oh, that smells so good. That smells of holidays. Yeah, it smells like coconut and melon and cocktail. Yeah, coconut breeze, that's good. What you basically do, you wet your hair. You don't need to wash it, just wet it. So what I normally do, if you've got a spray bottle with water in, just sop your hair down. And then, or do what I do, just fill my hands full of water and just keep patting it in and rubbing it in till it's, my hair's really damp. And then you slather it on. Now you can leave it, even if you leave it for 3 minutes before you wash your hair, it would make a difference. But my mum actually sleeps in it, so she'll do it on night time and then she'll actually sleep in it. And you can do that when I've been on holiday. I've put it on in the morning before, say I went to the beach around the pool, and I've just put it on my hair and left it all day before I wash it out. You can leave it as long as you like or as short as you like, really. But they recommend about 20 minutes. But that's the Coconut Breeze. And I think this is what QVC's Super Size of the Month or Beauty Pick of the Month is, the massive version of this. So that's a good way to try it anyway. Right, what's that? What's that? What's that? Little bag, and it is, oh, Decleor Aromessence Mandarine soothing oil serum with essential oils, and it is a 5 mil size of the Aromessence Mandarine. Now I'm gonna have to look this up, I'm afraid, because some of these things you probably will have to go on the website and find out a little bit more about. But I know Decleor are famous for their Aromessence oils. They're one of the first brands, I think, to actually produce facial oils and body oils and all the rest of it. And they're supposedly amazing. I've heard really good things about them. I've never tried them because they are actually quite expensive. And I'm never really sure which one to try, but I think this is the Mandarin one. So I don't know, I'll have to check what skin type this one's for. But I think you can use them, I think, is it during the day or during the night? Because I know they've got balms for some, and they've got oils and balms. And I think one's at night and one's not. But I'll definitely have a look at how to use this. And I will give that a go, definitely. I have only tried a few Decleor products, but they do seem very nice. They smell nice, and everything that smells nice is always good. Right, something else wrapped up in stuff. Ah, right, I know what this is. Yes, I've already got this, so I might be giving this one away. We'll see. It is a full-size Essie nail polish, which is 13.5 mils. And it is in their famous shade Mint Candy Apple. I own this. I think there's a lot, majority of people who beauty blog and light nail polish own Essie Mint Candy Apple. So I probably will do one of the nails of the day with this at some point, or I might repost my nails of the day and do a giveaway for this, give this away. It would be a UK only one, but I probably will give this away because I think I own at least one bottle of that already. But well worth it. That's nearly like half the cost of the box and a bottle of polish, so that's good. Oh god, that is so cute. Pixi Glow Tonic, and it is probably the cutest bottle of Pixi Glow Tonic I think I've ever seen. Cutest bottle of anything, actually. Can we see? No, I'm having issues with focusing today and I don't know why it's doing that. But yeah, it is a tiny 15 ml bottle of Pixi Glow Tonic. That is so cute. That is perfect for holidays. If you're going away on holiday, that is perfect. I just rave and rave about Pixi Glow Tonic. I think it's amazing. I think it's made such a difference to my skin. I'm trying to find your bottle in here, but I don't think it's in here. It just makes such a difference. It doesn't make your my skin tingle like, say, an Alpha H Liquid Gold is, so it's not as strong as that. But it's just something you can use every day. It is gentle. As I say, I just love it. It really helps if you've got a spray cow. It helps with a lot of areas. Big fan. Definitely recommend you give that a go and see if you like it. I know a couple of people have said it doesn't live up to the hype, but for me, it definitely does. Love that. Right, Molton Brown. I've got a funny relationship with Molton Brown. When QVC first came out, they had a lot of Molton Brown. Molton Brown was one of their biggest brands. My mum always used to buy kits for Christmas and always used to buy them for family and friends. And then they disappeared from QVC and you could only really get them on the concessions and the shops. And I've got to say, I don't have the best experience with customer services with Molton Brown counters. I went to one of their shops in London. I found the staff really rude. I spent £65 and they were really, I thought they were really rude. The guy in front of me spent less than I did, which, you know, fair enough. He spent less than I did and he got sweets, samples, and I got jack shit. So I didn't get that, why that was. And I should have probably complained and said, excuse me, why am I not getting samples? I've spent more money than he did. But no, I didn't. So, and my mum actually had a really bad experience with one of the Northeast counters. Well, you've a few years now, so, you know, people can have bad days and what have you. But she had a bad experience at one of the counters as well. So it's a brand I've probably stayed away from. And they've changed a lot over the years. They got rid of most of their skincare lines. I used to like some of the skincare products. They got rid of all of those. And now they're focused again on bath and body and hand wash and things like that. Now, some of the scents that they've had for years, I still love. They've renamed a few of them. They had a gorgeous one called ABC, which I think is Naranja now. It's like, oh no, it was basically, it was orange. And I like their Wang Zi, which they now call Ylang Ylang, and their eucalyptus. That was the one thing I continued to buy even when I couldn't get Monkey VC anymore, was the eucalyptus. I don't have any now because I found a couple of alternatives, but I do like that, and that is something I probably would continue to buy. But I think, but it just shows you, I think, when you have bad experiences on counters with or with staff, it does really put you off the brand. And I think with both me and my mum, it did. They are back on QVC now again, though. So obviously, it's possible to buy the products from QVC. And this is one of the new ones. This is Dewy, Lily of the Valley, and Star Anise. So we're going to see what this is like. Oh. Okay, I will probably be buying this again. Oh, right, how can I describe what this smells like? Right, first of all, you don't get any, I'm not getting any of the Anise, I've got to be honest. For me, the first Michael Kors fragrance, that's what that smells like. I had a shower gel and the first Michael Kors fragrance, I never had the perfume, but for some reason I had the shower gel. Oh, and that's what that smells like. It's the Lily of the Valley, it's the floral, it's like sort of really heady floral with a bit of a tang mixing in. I can't wait to actually put that in the shower, and I think I'm going to put that over there and put it straight in the shower. That is really good. Okay, if that smells half as nice, I'm a Molton Brown convert again. I have got some little bits of events and things since, and you know, I do, as I say, I've got no issue with the products themselves. It was more the stuff that I had the issue with at the time. But oh, that's good. I like that. I really like that. Definitely. The name probably puts it up, like doesn't really describe it very well, because as I say, I'm not really getting the anise from it, but I'm getting some lovely florals and things, so that is really good. That is a 50ml size. That's good. I like that. Big fan of that. Oh god, there's more. They said there was a lot in this box. How many items? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. About 8, 9 items in this one. So it's a lot of stuff. 10 items maybe. Right, next one. Tea Tree Australian Body Care. I'm going to try and... yes, if you can see that a little bit better. The Australian Body Care Skin Wash, and this is the 50ml size. Yeah, here's one I just randomly picked off the shelf. Tea Tree. We like Tea Tree in this house. I can even see body lotion, Australian Body Care body lotion there. This stuff is brilliant. If you go on holiday, summer, it's an essential for sweaty. So if you get sweaty, if you get spots, if, I don't know, you get irritation. Cannot live without this. Me and my mum cannot live without this brand as a whole. We always take it on holiday. Insects do not like it. Mosquitoes do not really like it. So if you use the body lotion and the wash when you're on holiday, the insects will not bite you as much as what they would have done. And yeah, basically if you get spots, if you wax, if you shave, you need this. Spots, spotty backs, spotty chests, breakouts, oiliness, dryness, anything this is good for. Yeah, really pleased to have a little one of this. I don't know if I'm going away on holiday this year. I probably am not. I know. I really need a holiday. But I don't think I am. But if you do, get this kit purely for this so you can take it away with you, because you will find a million and one uses. Plus, if you're a pet owner, wash your hands with it. We wash our hands a lot with this, hence it's near the bathroom sink. Yes, we have nice hand wash as well, but this is good. Antibacterial. Really good, thoroughly recommend it. Really pleased to have that. So what next? Elemis. Oh, right, now I've never tried this, so I love Elemis as a brand. Just an example of some of the Elemis line in my bathroom. But never tried this one. This is the Gentle Foaming Face Wash, and I've got to be honest and say I've never tried this. In fact, I'm not even sure I've heard of this. I do like Elemis cleansers. I've got the cleansing balm at the moment, which is one of my favourites. As I say, slightly prefer my Hardy Dew with the smell, but I do like the Elemis one. I've got the new oil and micellar water to try, and I also like the tri-enzyme, but I do like the course of the tri-enzyme facial treatments, and that's really good for when you like block pores and just your skin looks dull and a bit bumpy. Now, I've never tried this before. This says, deeply purifying foamy cleanser removes pollutants and impurities whilst respecting the skin's natural oils. The complexion is left balanced, comfortable and refreshed. So it's got a bit of orange in it, nutmeg, lemon, fig. Don't know what, prakai seed oil? I'm not sure what that is. Yes, yeah, coriander. It's got a lot of sort of citrusy and spicy notes in it. So I'm looking forward to giving that a go. I'll see if it's sealed. Yeah, it is. But definitely looking forward to giving that a try, seeing what that's like. I know a lot of people say you shouldn't use sort of foaming cleansers on your face, but I do love the feeling a bit of foam gives. My skin's not dry. I think you can deal with a bit of foam every now and then. But definitely excited to give that a go. Right, we're on the final two. Now, next. Doll 10 Lip Velvet in Material Girl. Now, this lady who comes on QVC, I think her name is Doris Dalton. She was a former Mrs. America. I think she had, she suffered from cancer. She's a cosmetologist. I think she's a qualified doctor or cosmetologist. And she comes on with a makeup range, and it looks really good. I've got a few of her products, which I keep meaning to review, and I will do at some point. I'm definitely going to try and get some of those reviewed. And I really like the products. She does one of the nicest cream blushes I think I've ever used. And yeah, she's just a real character. She's really fun to watch. Our products are really good for covering like imperfections, rosacea and things like that. And yeah, she's just quite fun to watch. I'm a bit of a QVC-aholic and I do tend to watch a lot of the beauty shows, and she is quite good. Now, this is what they call a lip velvet. Oh, and it's so pretty. It's that gorgeous sort of nudie pinky colour. It looks a bit purpley mauve on here, but I will swipe a bit for you. Oh, that's so pretty. Yeah, that's lovely, like that. We'll definitely wear that. But it's like that sort of, I don't know, the sort of the matte, the thing of the, all about these matte lip lacquers and lip paints and lip matte liquid lipsticks, if your lips are dry, I'm sorry, they don't do anything for you. They really don't. I've seen some pictures of people with the Kylie Jenner ones on, and literally they look puckered dry, and I just want to cover lip balm them in lip balm. This gives the same idea as does the Elemis one that I'm giving away at the moment. Don't forget to check my blog out to enter that giveaway. It's got a sort of, it's the idea of a matte, but it's got a bit of a shine to it, the sort of velvety, satiny feel to it. That is really, really pretty, and I'm really looking forward to using that. But yeah, that looks really pretty. It doesn't look as though it's going to like suck the moisture out of your face at first attempt, like some of them do. And yeah, the colour's brilliant. Really like that. Very pleased with that. Definitely give that a turn on the lips. Oh, I found something else. Yeah, it must have been 10 products because I found something else. Right, this works. Pillow spray is excellent. Thoroughly recommend the pillow mist if you haven't already tried that. I do, despite having chronic fatigue syndrome, one of the symptoms of chronic fatigue syndrome and fibromyalgia, which I also have, is insomnia. And I do get awful insomnia spells. I mean, ridiculous. I mean, I have times where I haven't slept for more than 24 hours. And nothing in this world can make me go to sleep. But the thing to go to sleep, I think, sometimes is getting yourself in the right frame of mind. And their pillow mist does exactly that. I don't normally put it on the pillows, I've got to be honest, because that's a bit much. It's where my face goes. So I tend to put my duvet on my sheets. And it's lovely. It's full of, I think there's lavender. There's all sorts of like herbs and things in. And it's nice. It just, you just inhale it and right, think of sleep, think of sleep. And that's what it kind of does. Now, I don't know what this is. This is something different from them. I haven't tried a lot from them. This is the In Transit Camera Close-Up Mask, Moisturiser and Primer in One. This sounds interesting. Not too much about this. It says apply a clean skin and massage until absorbed, and all what you should and shouldn't do with it. So this is another one. I'm getting it sealed, so I won't open it until a thing. But I'm going to have a look at the QVC website and see if I can find out what this actually does and what this is supposed to do. Sounds really interesting. Bit of everything in one, so we'll see how that works. It's obviously something to perfect your skin, I would assume, given the name Camera Close-Up. But yeah, that sounds really interesting. That's a 20ml size. And the final thing is from a brand called Molly Beauty. Now, Molly Beauty in the UK, I think you can get it in Ulta. I've never been to an Ulta. If I ever do get back to the States in the near future, I need to go to an Ulta. My lucky friend is going to New York and Boston this late in the autumn, and I'm so jealous. Anyway, Molly Beauty. She's crazy. She does makeup. She's done makeup for Beyonce. I'm trying to think. All basically stars, starlets and all the rest of it. She does a lot of celebrities, but Beyonce is one of her biggies that she does a lot of Beyonce. And how good did she look though in that photo shoot? All these pregnant women looking amazing in photo shoots. Cheryl and that L'Oreal thing. Yeah, I know it's probably stuff full of extensions, but total pregnancy glow looks amazing on Cheryl. Anyway, back to Molly. So she's a celebrity makeup artist, American, I think she's, is she Filipino? I think she's Filipino, and she is amazing. Literally, she's hysterically funny to watch. She's very, very talented. A lot of her formulas are very innovative. She does a lot of different things. She was in the first to actually do use, like, say, a silicone product as a matte down. She was not a big fan of loose powder or anything like that. She was one of the first, like, primers. Her mascara is really good. I haven't tried a lot of her things. I've got to be honest, in the UK, I think her stuff is quite expensive. So I've only tried a few bits and pieces, but a concealer. She does like a two-phase concealer. So you get the concealer and you get the setting powder. I've got that and that is really good and that just lasts forever. So that's really good. She does a liquid lipstick as well. Is it Blossom? She does a nice liquid lipstick that I really like as well. So yes. Anyway, this is one of their shadow sticks. Now I've seen these a few times on. And, oh, that's lovely. How lovely is that? Oh, it's sort of a creamy champagne-y ivory. And the colour is Moonlight. That is so pretty. I can imagine that'd be really nice. Yeah, that's lovely. Are gonna be, yeah, you can see that. You can just about see that. That's lovely. That feels really smooth. It's a bit like a MAC shade stick. Which, do MAC still make shade sticks? I'm not sure they do. But I love this type of thing and eyeshadows and pencils and all the rest of it because they're really quick. When you can't be bothered, it's quick just to like swoosh it on and not blend it in. That's lovely. I think these are quite expensive actually, so I'm really pleased to give them a go. Yeah, so although I think there's quite a few mini products in this Tilly box, I think there's a lot of products that I really can't wait to use. That Doris Dalton lipstick, the Dalton lipstick, that looks amazing. I just can't wait to put that on my lips. Elemis product, it's not what I've tried, so I'm excited to try that. It's got a couple of staples in things that I use anyway. The tea tree skin wash and the glow tonic. Only thing that, as I say, that doesn't rock me is the nail polish, and it's only because I've already got it. But as I say, I'll pass that on somehow. This works. I'll have to find out more about that, and I'll have to find a bit more out about the Decleor product as well. And that Molton Brown stuff has really surprised me. That smells amazing to me. Can't wait to try that. So for £20, I think that was a pretty decent box. And the two makeup products, you probably well got your money's worth. Even with like the Essie polish as well. I really like the idea of it. You know what's in it. And obviously, if you do like it, you can go onto the QVC website and you can buy the full sizes. They're also brilliant, the QVC website. So you can go and actually look at the products, find the products, find out what they do. Sometimes you can watch a video presentation of the product, and obviously customers leave their own reviews, their independent reviews, so the customers leave their reviews about what they think. Some of them I think you've got to take with a pinch of salt. I think that with most reviews, because everyone's different and we like different things, we have different expectations. But for £20 with free postage, I think that's pretty decent, and I'll definitely try and get the other one, the next one, as soon as it's out. I'll leave a link below so you can find out more about Tilly Box yourself. As I say, I think it's only in the UK at the moment, but you'd have to check with if you've got QVC in your country whether they've got that. So I'll leave a link below, and I'll also do your full list and sizes of the products and let you know what's in there and where something's got a full size or I can find a price equivalent. I'll stick that on as well for you. So yeah, very pleased with that all in all. As I say, I knew what was in it, but always good to get things that you know that you'll like. So don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to let me know what you think about this box. As I say, don't forget to check my blog out. I'll link that below as well, because I've got another mask giveaway going on at the moment. And I will hopefully see you soon with another video.